President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. urged to finally take a stand on POGOs as more issues linked to the industry surface. As Ian Ambrosio tells us, the ongoing search of an illegal offshore gaming hub in Pampanga yielded suspected Chinese military uniforms.
The Provincial Director of Pampanga PNP Police, Colonel Levy Hope Basilio, was relieved from her post as investigation is ongoing in Lucky South 99 POGO hub in Porac. This came days after the relief of the Porac Municipal Police Chief. The Deputy Provincial Director for Administration of the Pampanga PPO, Police Lieutenant Colonel Maylani Castillo, will temporarily take over Basilio's post. The relief comes as authorities continue to search the buildings inside the POGO hub. So far, 6 pairs of Chinese military uniforms have been recovered by the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission and the Philippine National Police since Tuesday. The uniforms had the initials of the PLA, or People's Liberation Army, the Chinese military force.
We need confirmation from our foreign counterparts. Ina-avoid natin dito mamaya mga props lang yan. Ano? Mamaya mga nabili lang nila sa mga surplusan yan. Ano? And we don't want to spread fake news. Ano? Kaya we need to validate first.
According to the Armed Forces of the Philippines, this does not prove there are spies present in the country.
We are trying to look at the veracity of the report, whether they're legit uniforms. And these are also very few in number, no, to be part of a troop. So we do not want to unnecessarily cause panic to the general public.
The PNP also believes there should be a thorough investigation to determine the authenticity of the military uniforms.
Kukontak po tayo ng research para ikumpara po kung ito po ba talagang mga uniforme na nakumpiska po natin ay ito po yung mga usual na uniforms na sinusuot po ng ibang bansa po.
Meantime, Paok has named the people behind Lucky South 99.
Yung the facility is now allegedly being managed by Whirlwind Corporation, ano? Ito naman nililis nung dalawang kumpanya, namely yung Sinseng IT startup with its owners being represented by a certain Catherine Cassandra Ong. Yun yung status ng license nila, sa ngayon unknown pa rin, ano? And yung Lucky South 99 Outsourcing Incorporated, yung owners naman is being represented by a certain Norman G. Macapagal. Ito yung former HR head nila. As of December 2023, may pending application pa ito sa PAGCOR.
Philippine lawmakers are now working to remove POGOs in the country. Senate Deputy Minority Leader Risa Ontiveros says she will file a bill to repeal Republic Act 11590, or the act taxing Philippine offshore gaming operations. Ontiveros also appealed to President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to put an end to POGOs. Over at the lower chamber, a bill seeking to prohibit and criminalize the operations of POGOs has been filed by ACT Teachers Party List Representative Franz Castro.
Dapat ay magsalita na rin si President Marcos Jr. kung sasabihin niya na ibaban talaga yung mga POGO. Dito ay mainam yon, pero kung di siya nagsasabi, baka ano bang masasabi natin diyan? May pinoprotektahan ba?
But Albay 2nd District Representative Joey Salceda is suggesting that only non-compliant POGOs should have their license revoked. Salceda believes PAGCOR has been strictly implementing rules on POGOs, as well as a collection of revenues from POGO operators. Z. Ann Ambrosio, ABS-CBN News.
Meanwhile, the Philippine Amusement and Gaming Corporation continues to defend POGOs. It warrants outlawing POGOs, which PAGCOR now calls as an internet gaming licensees, may drive illegitimate operators underground. PAGCOR Chairman Alejandro Tenco says this would pose a bigger headache to authorities tasked to monitor the IGLs. He adds the government may lose annual revenues of over 20 billion pesos, but Tenco says they will respect the decision of Congress on the issue. The Duterte clan throwing their support behind fugitive televangelist Apolo Quiboloy. Former President Rodrigo Duterte accusing government of overkill in its hunt for Quiboloy. He said the police used excessive and unnecessary force in its attempt to serve Kibuloy's arrest warrant. Duterte also accusing the Marcos administration of blatantly violating human rights and exhibiting a lack of self-restraint. His daughter, Vice President Sara Duterte, also questioned the display of force. She said there should be a humane enforcement of law and promotion of justice in the Philippines. Over 100 police personnel stormed Kibuloy's Davao City properties on Monday, but his supporters barricaded the entrances to keep the police out. The Philippine National Police defending Monday's operation to arrest Pastor Apollo Kibuloy. The PNP said it followed legal security protocols when it served the warrant last Monday. Despite their effort, authorities were unable to locate the fugitive pastor. For Senator Risa Ontiveros, the failed attempts to arrest the pastor show a breakdown of intelligence. She also appeals to the police to ensure none of their officers are being influenced by Kibuloy and his allies, including former President Rodrigo Duterte. The Philippine Justice Department releases a photo to disprove the supposed release of expelled lawmaker Arnulfo Teves Jr. from detention in Timor-Leste. The photo shows Teves in handcuffs after he was released and subsequently rearrested to stand trial for his extradition case. His lawyer, Ferdinand Topacio, earlier shared a different photo and claimed Teves was released from detention. Teves is facing multiple murder charges in the Philippines for the 2023 assassination of Negros Oriental Governor Roel Degamo and 9 others. The governor's widow, Pamplona Mayor Janice Degamo, said in a Facebook post, Teves enjoyed 37 minutes of freedom before he was rearrested. She also accused him of using his short-lived freedom to mislead the public. The Philippine military urged to prepare as external threats grow. Speaking to troops in Isabela Monday, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. said external threats to the country's security have become more pronounced and worrisome as a result of heightened tensions in the Indo-Pacific region. He adds the proximity of the Philippines to Taiwan makes the country an area of interest for China. Marcos says this means Manila should be well prepared for any eventuality. Aside from the Taiwan issue, the Philippines has a long-standing territorial spat with China, which claims almost all of the South China Sea. Beijing's expansive claims have already been invalidated by Manila's 2016 arbitral victory. Meanwhile, Chinese vessels continue to swarm the West Philippine Sea. Around 150 Chinese ships were monitored last week, with its warships within Ayungin Shoal nearly doubling in number. Dozens of ships were also spotted in Ruzal Reef and Escuela Shoal, where China conducted its illegal military drills and alleged island-building activities. The Philippine Navy says the increase in Chinese presence in Philippine waters is worrisome.
Their presence by itself is already escalatory. Whatever actions they do in furtherance of their illegal, coercive, aggressive, and deceptive presence will only point out that they have no right to be within our exclusive economic zone. The presence of the PLA Navy in Sabina is a reflection of their presence in the entire West Philippine Sea.
Amid China's aggression, the Philippine Navy assures the public it will keep its guard up.
We have increased patrols. We are involving our partners and allies. We are not the only one concerned. Even other countries are concerned about that. This is not only a problem of the Philippines, it's a problem of ASEAN and the international community.
Last week, the Swedish...
Let's now get an update on the weather from PAGASA forecaster Benison Estradeja.
Good morning, Ms. Bettina, and all our viewers. We currently have easterlies affecting the eastern sections of southern Luzon and Visayas. This will bring cloudy skies, partly cloudy to cloudy skies with isolated rain showers or thunderstorms over Bicol region, Eastern Visayas, and Caraga region. And as early as this morning, possible cloudy skies with some rain showers and thunderstorms over Davao region and nearby areas such as Soksabjen and Bangsamoro region. For Metro Manila and the rest of the country, also expect some partly cloudy to cloudy skies, especially this morning up until the afternoon. And late afternoon until evening, mostly cloudy skies with some isolated rain showers and thunderstorms as well. And due to the easterlies, warm weather conditions will prevail in most parts of our country. For Metro Manila, range of temperature is from 25 to 34 degrees Celsius, whereas for Baguio, from 18 up to 24 degrees Celsius. And based on our latest satellite animation, we're not seeing any low pressure area or tropical cyclone to affect our country in the next 2 to 3 days. And that's the latest from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center. This is Benny Estareja reporting.
Thank you very much for that update, Benison.